rule that the policy draft that they have launched just recently, I think it's the right way. What they have, what we have been requesting the government for a very long time, because restrictions are always not the way to regulate any industry, and restrictions are only going to increase the problems in terms of large number of drones coming into the system. So almost everybody becomes illegal, and you won't find what is the products which are used for proper applications and what are the ones which is actually used for illegal applications. So if you open up the market and make it easier for people to come into the system, get it registered, we can easily find out the people who are involved in illegal activities. So it is in the right way, but the thing is, it's still in the draft progress process. So it has to be ratified by the government, it has to be released as a gazette notification, which we hope they will do. Definitely, it's a big boon for entire world in terms of technology. There is no limit to what its capabilities are. And the positive aspects of drone technology simply outweigh the negatives that you may find in few places. So definitely it's a big positive thing for the society as well as the overall economy as well. It has its own issues. Obviously any technology which could be potentially be used for certain illegal activities is always a challenge. So it's easy access in the market. Yes, it does pose a certain question, but it is also about the people who are involved in the business, the manufacturers, or it could be the sellers or even the buyers. They have to make sure that they take the responsibility, because no matter what the government is gonna, you know, follow or form a rule or something like that, if individuals or the companies don't follow the rules, or if they try to create, you know, go behind and try to do some illegal activities, finding something, some loopholes, it's a problem. So both the government has to make it easier. At the same time, it's also about the companies and individuals who are involved in this industry to be responsible enough. In this, two things are there. One, if the purchase of a drone is made a little bit easier, I'm not saying completely opening up, but if it's made a little bit easier, these manufacturers and sellers, they would be able to register each and every drone, and it goes all automatically to the government database with the, you know, the address and the phone number and Aadhaar card and all these details about them. It's going to be easily available. So that is number one. The other way is, yes, radar will not be able to pick up drones which are smaller in size, but there is another way. You have anti-drone technologies available, which are used for specifically detecting drones, and they're able to even deactivate the drones, attack a drone, shoot down a drone, or take control of the drone itself. So there are different ways to achieve that. You have radio frequency controllers which match with the frequency of the drone, and instead of the pilot who is operating it, it goes to the control of that government agency which is operating the anti-drone technology. Then you have guns which can typically detect a drone and then shoot it down. So there are many other technologies which I think if the government is able to invest in terms of technology with other agencies, they would be easily able to do that. It's not a very complicated thing, and it's easily available in many other countries. Again, the same thing, if the industry is opened up for research, even there are a lot of local companies who have the capability, including us, to work on this anti-drone technology as well. Because somebody who has the technology to make it, we also know how we can hack it also.
If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe to our channel.